Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Brianna. I do fashion, lifestyle, some DIY tutorials, fun videos like that. I also have a blog, be sure to go check it out. I'm most active on Instagram, and I also have a TikTok, which I'm trying to grow, so be sure to go follow me. But yeah, today's video is all about Glamnetic. And I am super excited to be trying these today. I am really into like falsies, and so their predominant product is false lashes. So I got these, but they also do press-on nails. So I also got a pair of those. So I'll be trying both of these today, my very first time. I have never used a falsie that is magnetic, so this is going to be a little bit interesting, but I've heard amazing things about this brand and they've been featured everywhere. Let me just pull up my notes. They've been featured on Forbes, Birdie, Refinery 29. I really trust Refinery 29. So I'm really excited to check them out today. I also wanted to mention, so they have a variety of different lengths, styles for different eye shapes as well. The ones that I got are called Venus. I think they're for more of a cat eye, I may be wrong, but I really like them. I think that they were, they had a little bit of a flare, but they weren't too crazy, which is why I like them. Also, I think that they are the first magnetic lashes to have colored lashes, so that's really exciting. Like I said, this is my first time trying it, so I do have the magnetic liner, and it says to make sure that your line is, I believe, kind of thick, but also 80% dry, so I'm going to be doing that on camera. Hopefully it goes perfectly. And yeah, I'll also be trying out these nails. So yeah, and I'll also be trying out these nails. So, these nails are in, they're called Wild Card. I'll be sure to show them a little bit closer up as I get into that. But yeah, let's get started. Okay, so first things first, it says to shake the liner a little bit, and you can hear it kind of mixing in there. So just to make sure that it is all mixed up. And then it says, just like any other product, you want to swatch it first, just to make sure, ooh, I like the way that goes. You want to swatch it just to make sure that you're not like allergic to it. And I'm just gonna let that sit for a second. And while I'm doing that, I'm going to open my lashes. Again, these are in, these are called Venus. If I can open it, use my scissors. So they have 5 different magnets on them, so you are able to cut them to your desired length if you want them a little bit shorter. Probably will right now. And then it also says, I'm scared. Okay, it comes off so easy. I didn't know to take off the lining or not. But yeah, just like any other lashes, I'm probably just going to curl them a little bit, which it doesn't seem like you really have to do because they are pretty flexible. And then I'm going to measure them. Okay, so I just read the little strip that I was afraid to take off is an anchor. I believe that's what they use for other magnetic lashes when you want to clip it on both sides. Like I said, this is my first time using magnetic lashes. I'm a huge falsies fan, but magnets I have never tried before. Okay, so I'm just going to measure them. I actually think it should be fine if I put it all the way on my inner corners. Okay, So it has a couple tips. It says cut the magnetic lashes down to eye width. Apply liner on lash line and to adhere lashes. Make sure that the magnets make a connection with the magic liner. You may also use anchors on the inner and outer corner. I probably won't do that. Okay, let's just go for it. I think that the lashes or the liner does have to be, of course, wherever you want to put the lashes. It says a wing is optional. I'm probably going to do a wing just because that's what I'm more comfortable with. I don't know how I'm going to feel about this felt pen. I usually do it with a little bit of a different applicator, but I think it'll be fine. So if you're good with felt pens or felt tips, you're going to be awesome at this. Sorry guys, I have my mirror down here. And it does say to go all the way from the inner corner to the outer corner. This is pretty easy to use, actually. And again, I want to make it with enough application so it'll stick, but it doesn't need to be any different than my regular liner. That wing is not bad. I mean, it's not my best wing, but like for the first time that I'm using this kind of felt tip, I think it wasn't bad. Okay, that wing was kind of bad, not gonna lie. But I don't think it's that bad. Okay, so you want it to sit, it says for about 20 to 60 seconds, I believe, depending on how much you applied. So while I'm letting it sit, I am going to put one coat of mascara, and I'm just going to use the Glossier mascara. One, because like it does lengthen my lashes, and it doesn't give, like, it's more of a natural look, so I do want to be able to see what the lashes look like. It says also it doesn't recommend putting on mascara with the lashes just because you don't want to ruin them and it makes them last longer, which is totally understandable. See how it's just like a simple lift? It's not like a vavoom. I have other mascaras that definitely do give that better effect, but I really do want these to be as natural as possible right now, so I can really see the lashes in effect. Okay, now it's time for the magic. So I'm just going to take my tweezers. I'm going to take my lashes. I usually don't need to use tweezers when I put on my lashes, but I do want to do it right this time. Oops. I should probably do the other eye first, because that eye, in theory, would be a little bit more dry. Oh, it's sticking to the tweezers. I'm done. So it says you can use your fingers to blend it with your regular lashes, just like you would other falsies with glue. And it looks pretty good. Again, when you put your liner, you want to do it as close to the waterline as possible, or as close to your waterline as possible. It does say that you can use your own liner, like say you want like a brown liner underneath, but just putting this one on top just so it has like a perfect connection. I think it looks pretty good, actually. Okay, let's do the other one so it doesn't dry out too much. Tip, don't put your metal tweezers super close to it just because it was sticking more. See, it's sticking more to my tweezers than to my eye. Because it is a magnet, duh. You can tell that like it is sticking just like it's glue, you know? And it doesn't feel like heavy, and it doesn't feel like weird. I feel like I definitely could have cut this one a little bit, actually. Okay. So, yeah, I could have cut this one. Or I could put more liner on that inner corner. It looks good. So here's what it looks like. Again, this is my very first attempt doing magnetic lashes. I have never done them like this before. I'm usually a glue girl, but like I said, there were amazing reviews on this one. Like I said, I think it's been like a really good experience so far. I'm gonna keep them on while I do my nails. I feel it, but not any more than I feel my regular falsies, so I do like that. Again, it also comes with some anchors in case that's what you're wanting to do. That's probably what would fix this inner corner right here, and also more liner. I just could have cut them. I could have just made it a little bit, you know, put some more liner on the inside. Super easy fixes. It seems to not, like, I'm tugging on them and I feel like they'll stay. I don't want to tug too hard. Oh, look, it came off. Yeah, I really had to, like, really tug at it for it to come off, so it feels like it'll stay, like, definitely all day, all night if that's your thing. Definitely my thing. So I'm gonna put on the nails and let's see how they do. Okay, so now I'm going to do my nails, which look totally bad right now, I'm not gonna lie. I have been loving press-on nails recently just because during the pandemic, I definitely don't really want to go places if I don't have to, which includes the nail salon. I do have really small fingers, so that's always interesting with press-on nails. But for the most part, it works out. So, it says remove any nail polish, wash and dry hands, push back cuticles, sanitize with alcohol pads. So, first I'm going to just see which nails fit me. Again, this one is called Wild Card. So they have a ton of just different variety of patterns, which I absolutely love. I think it's really fun and cool. Mm-hmm. Okay guys, so here's the new me. I did put on my lashes and my nails. You can see them. They're super cute. I absolutely love them. I like cannot wait to post them everywhere on Instagram, and I will be showing you what the pictures look like in a second. But as for my lashes, again, I love them. I did put a little bit more liner on the inner corners so that they will stick a little bit better. I read after that you should make sure to make the liner as thick as the magnets are, at least, so that it does have a good hold. So I usually put a little bit of this thinner line closer to my water ducts, but for this one I did make it a little bit thicker, and it doesn't look bad. It doesn't look bulky or anything. Again, like, I already forgot that they're there, and they have been on for about probably like an hour now, because I did put them on, do my nails, I took a couple pictures, and I honestly love them. They don't feel heavy or anything like that. And I'm sure, like, if I use the anchors, that they would last even longer, or, you know, I'm sure it feels the exact same. I don't have a lot of shooting today, so that's why I didn't do that. But I'm loving my nails. I'm loving my new lashes. I definitely recommend you try them out. I unfortunately don't have a code or anything, but I definitely recommend you checking them out, maybe on Instagram, and see a lot of the testimonials before you buy. They have a lot of different types of lashes and nails. Again, these were my favorites in both categories. And let me know in the comments below if you've tried them, if you want to try them, and all that fun stuff. So be sure to like, subscribe, comment, all of that, and join me for my next video.